As you can tell by the title, I figured I would do a braces 101, just to recap everything and to kind of get those out there, you know, you adults that may be considering braces or may have just got braces, and you just kind of want to know what to expect and what it's really like, because you hear of stories, but you know, why not just put it on a video out there, base it off of experience? And I found a really great article that I'm going to refer to. So you might see me looking down a few times, but there is some very beneficial and helpful information in this article that I'm so eager to share with you guys, because it is point on with everything that I am actually currently going through. If you're new to braces or you're thinking about getting them, this is a great launching point for you guys. One of the things that held me back from getting braces was it feeling more kind of like a taboo thing, because you see a lot of kids getting braces and not so much adults. A lot of adults are taking the plunge to get braces to fix their bite or to straighten their teeth. This is going to be like a 6-part video just to kind of break everything down for you guys. This is going to be everything that you need to know before you actually spend the time and the money to get them. So if you don't already have an orthodontist, you can get a recommendation from a friend or actually from just your dentist. That is actually what I did. I got a recommendation for 2 orthodontists. Like with most things that involves a lot of money and your time, you always want to try to get 2 opinions. Orthodontists can vary in their treatment approach. If you don't like what one orthodontist says, get an opinion from another orthodontist until you're conscious of the decision that is made, because you don't know if one orthodontist wants to do tooth extractions and the other one says, no, we don't have to do that, or something a little more invasive like jaw surgery. And these consultations, you guys, are usually free, so don't hesitate when you go in. I was very lucky that when I went into my orthodontist, they weren't pushy. You know, they were like, well, this is gonna be the treatment plan, this is what we can do, and it sounded really, really great and amazing, and I wanted to slap all of my money right then and there and be like, sold, but I really needed to think on it and discuss, you know, the option, well, not really the options, but like the price, because my insurance didn't cover any of it. So I had to review all this to my husband, and we had to discuss it together as a team to decide if this was something that we could actually afford at the time. So definitely take those measures when deciding, and don't just jump right into it. Take some time to think about it. The orthodontist isn't going anywhere. A lot of questions that people probably get when you're an adult and you got braces is, how much did they cost? Braces are typically around $5,000 for your upper and your lower for a maximum of at least 2 years or 24 months. The cost can be slightly lower or higher depending on where you live. Something really amazing from this article I was reading was that if you can't afford the braces, you can actually check in to see if there is a private orthodontist in your area, a school, and many times the school will provide a low-cost orthodontic care, and the orthodontists that are in training will actually have an experienced professor, I'm trying to talk and read this at the same time, who are often orthodontists in their own private practice. Another important thing is to research your health plan to see what kind of coverage you might or may not have based on getting braces as an adult. My insurance, that was something I actually did, so I was a little bit prepared and educated when I went in as far as my insurance goes on coverage. I have their app and I'm able to view what kind of coverage I have for all kinds of different things, whether it's dental or medical. And basically on dental, I am not covered as far as orthodontist goes. Now, if I was 26 years old and a student still in school, I would have been covered and they would have slapped $1,000 on to the braces. So I would have got that as a discount off, and it would have been spread out through treatment. It wouldn't have just been like, well, here's $1,000, just take it off of what you're gonna charge. That's not how it works, because they only charge you for as long as you're in treatment, so you don't want to pay more than you're supposed to. And you really want to be realistic about your own expectations. Is this something that you really want to do? Are you actually going to be determined to stay in your braces for this long period of time? This is something that you got to deal with 24/7 until you get them off. A list of some great questions to ask your orthodontist are, will Invisalign or other invisible braces work for me? If not, why? Can I have ceramic braces on just upper or both uppers and lowers? Do you treat with Damon brackets? Often these are a good alternative if you have to have any extractions. Will I need metal braces? Will I need rubber bands to correct my bite? Will I need headgear or other appliances? If so, how long will I need to wear it and for how many hours per day? Will any teeth be extracted? That's the big one that was for me before I decided if I wanted to go through with braces. Will treatment change my facial profile in any way? And if so, how? Will I need jaw surgery? When? Will braces only straighten my teeth or will they also improve my bite? How often will I need to come to the office for adjustments? If I have a poking wire, can I just call and drop in and get it clipped? Or do I have to have an appointment for that? What is the total cost? Do you accept insurance? How is the cost broken down? Do you offer a payment plan? How much pain and discomfort will I be in? Does the cost of my braces also include the retainers? What type of retainers do you typically give your patients? Yes, they've got more than one retainer these days, guys. So you took the plunge, you decided to get braces, now what's next? X-rays and molds. First of all, you usually need to get panoramic x-rays of your mouth, plus a full set of x-rays for your individual teeth. Now, I had the panoramic x-rays for my mouth. I did not get them for the individual teeth, unless that might come later on down the road, but starting off, they did not do that with me. They will take photographs, actual pictures from a camera, of your face and your teeth and your profile. So make sure you look nice on x-ray day. These pictures will be a permanent record in your file. In this article, it states that they will take molds of your teeth. I did not have molds taking of my teeth. I don't know if that depends on the type of braces you choose to get. I believe it does. But for the type of braces I went with, which were the ceramic, I did not have any molds of my teeth. Molds of your teeth is basically like a silly putty that they put on your upper and your lower teeth, and they let it sit there for about 30 seconds each, and then it just leaves a nice impression of your teeth so that they can, I'm assuming, adjust brackets for braces depending on the type of braces you choose to go with, where they will fit accordingly to each of the teeth. Your orthodontist will review the x-rays of your teeth and the molds, and then he will discuss, or she, with you the treatment plan. And usually during the consult, they will do all of this with you in the same day, so come ready and prepare to spend some of your day with them. During this time, it's a crucial time for you to ask any necessary questions that you might have on your mind. So basically, this is, you know, what you got to do before you actually go through and have the braces put on. If you've got tight spaces between your teeth, they may recommend spacers or rubber bands to open those areas up. Or you might have some cavities that really need to be filled, even a root canal. I actually had to, back in January, I had my braces put on, well, my top ones. I go on the 17th of May to have my bottom ones put on. I, back in January, had the finishing touches of my crown placed after I had a root canal last year, and I had a couple fillings finished. So I had all teeth work done before I actually went and considered going to the orthodontist. This way I knew I didn't have anything holding me back. Should you need to have any teeth extracted, they will let you know. And usually this will happen during treatment. Sometimes it can happen before. I guess it depends on the crowding. But normally it happens during the treatment process. You should have your teeth professionally cleaned before you go in. So go in for a nice dental visit and have your teeth all cleaned so that before they place any appliances on your teeth, you don't have to worry about them being dirty. If you have very sensitive teeth, it's best to brush with Sensodyne or a toothpaste similar for the first 2 weeks before you go in to help desensitize your teeth. You can ask your orthodontist if he would rather you whiten your teeth before or after treatment. I did not get my teeth whitened before treatment. I had actually looked into it, but my dentist told me that your teeth are already white, you're really not going to tell much of a difference. So the toothpaste that I use that has been really amazing for me is the Colgate Optic White, and you can find it at your local retailer. It's normally under $4, and it's like a 3-ounce tube, and I use it twice a day, and it lasts me at least 4 weeks. So today's the day. What should you expect? Before you go to your orthodontist appointment, brush your teeth real good, floss them real good. Make sure you take a before picture, because pretty soon that crooked smile is gonna be straight and you wanna have an awesome before and after picture. Guys, you're gonna want to apply a thick coat of chapstick, Carmex, lip gloss, something, because these babies are gonna get dry. You're gonna be having your mouth open for a little bit while they put all these things in your mouth. So make sure you come prepared and bring that stuff for them lips, because let me tell you, my lips were so dry afterwards, and they're even dry now since I've had braces. They seems like they stay dried out more. I've actually been using Carmex, and it's really, really good stuff, because for me, it feels like it lasts longer on my mouth, and if I have any kind of chapped lips, it really helps in that area as well. So I'm gonna read down at this article so that I can explain to you guys exactly the process once they put the braces on. I'm sure you've seen the videos, but I will go ahead and go through and explain the process for you guys from this article. The dental assistant or the orthodontist will draw off your teeth and apply etchant to them, which is like, it tastes like a crazy glue, and it really does. It's not that great of a taste. So you wanna try not to get it on your tongue. The etchant basically prepares the surface of your teeth for the bonding cement that holds on the brackets. After that, the brackets are then placed on your teeth. A high intensity plasma light is then quickly applied to the surface of the bracket to set the bond. And whenever I had that done, it normally took her like, I think 30 seconds to a minute on each side. So she started on one side first, and then she put the brackets on and went to the other side. The wire, or what they call the arch wire, is then placed through the brackets. It shouldn't poke your cheek, but if it does, just tell the orthodontist or the assistant and they will clip it and make sure you're set to go before you go home. Little rubber bands or O-rings, or what they call ligatures, will then be placed over your brackets, which look like these little rubber bands. You can see mine are actually a really light blue, but I think they've toned down a little bit. They're not quite as bright as they were a week ago. These are what holds the wires to the brackets and creates that pressure filling that you'll get on your teeth. If you get Damon brackets, I think I'm pronouncing that right. It may be Damon brackets. Correct me if I'm wrong. Ligatures are not necessary. That's it. You're done. Each row of teeth takes about 45 minutes to an hour. They'll also give you some really fancy sunglasses to keep your eyes from the really bright light that they use to shine down on you while they're applying everything. This whole process does not hurt. You do not have to worry about getting any shots. Afterwards, you may want to take something for pain, because your mouth might be a little sore and tired from being open for so long. This is probably one of the questions that has always been in the back of my mind, and curiosity killed the cat. So at first you're gonna feel an unusual feeling of pressure on your teeth. If any of your teeth have metal brackets around them, it's gonna feel really weird, but not unbearable. And I shouldn't say that, because the article says that. So guys, from experience, it don't feel unbearable having something on your mouth, but the pressure sometimes feels a little unbearable. I'm not gonna lie. I won't sugarcoat it for you guys. Feeling your braces underneath your lip is a weird sensation at first, but you quickly get used to it after about a week. One very important tip is you're gonna wanna stick to soft foods for probably the first week after you've had your braces put on. You don't want nothing crunchy, nothing hard, nothing large, nothing that's gonna be difficult to bite or chew. Like some big sub sandwiches, or pizza, or burritos, or chicken fajitas, or salads with chunks of cucumber and all that jazz. Yeah, I made that mistake, you guys. I went straight for pizza and biscuits and chips, pretzels, Twizzlers. Yeah, I broke the rules a little bit, but I didn't break no brackets, so that's a good thing. So the first day you get your braces, it may not hurt as much as the next day, if any at all. I don't really remember my braces hurting me the first day I got them. I remember I went to go take a bite of a biscuit, like I just told you guys, and I felt a very intense pain, like up in the root of this tooth, my very front one right here. And I had only had my braces on at the time for I think 3 or 4 hours. So it didn't really take no time for my teeth to start adjusting to the braces, for me to start having sensitivity when chewing on something. It only hurt when I bit into that biscuit and I started noticing my bite was starting to change. So things start moving pretty rapidly quick. But as far as noticing change that quick, you don't, but you can definitely tell something's going on in your mouth. The second and the third day, you're really gonna feel it. I mean, it's gonna feel like someone took a baseball bat and just whacked you right in the mouth. I'm not kidding. Not kidding. I just had my braces tightened for the first time a week ago, and they're just now, like, this is day seven? Yeah, this is day seven since I've had my braces tightened for the first time, and they're just now, like, I can bite down, don't hurt, I can chew harder foods now. But yeah, it takes me a week for my teeth to actually adjust and not be as sensitive and tender. Now for this, they say you can take pain reliever like ibuprofen or Motrin, Advil, Tylenol, but I recently found out, you guys, and I was gonna save this for my next update, but since I am doing this video first, I'm gonna go ahead and put it in here. I found out from one of my friends who is a dental assistant, I believe, the people that they usually get that are in orthodontic treatment, they tell them to not take any kind of NSAIDs because it actually slows down the progress of the braces doing their job. I did not know this. So for the first day after I got my braces tightened, that next day I took it, and I mean, I was eating them ibuprofens like candy because I had ligature wires placed on this one and this one and this one, plus I went from a 14 gauge wire straight up to an 18, completely skipped 16, and so my mouth was completely aggravated and sore and mad at me. So ibuprofen was my best friend, and then I found out it can slow down the progress. So that next day, ever since, I have not taken no more ibuprofen. So I'm gonna try to stick with maybe some Tylenol for the first day, even though I don't feel like it works as good as ibuprofen and stuff does, because the other is an anti-inflammatory, but that is why it slows down the progress. And if I can find the article she was telling me about, I'll link it below this video in the description for you guys to read about too. So be super kind to yourself, guys. Don't go jumping into chips and pretzels and tortillas and all that stuff when eating. If you go out to eat, you know, just think about eating some softer foods when you place your order, because your teeth are gonna thank you in the end. If you don't, you're gonna be like, what was I thinking? Like, you want it so bad, but it's so uncomfortable to chew and try to eat it. Chewing may be difficult. You might bite the insides of your cheeks. You may have brackets rubbing up against the inside of your cheeks. But the good thing about that is they send you home with a dental kit, which includes wax, and you just take a glob of that and you place it on your bracket, and it helps protect, it creates like a barrier between the bracket and your cheek. Another great tip that I've seen in this article is to fill up on protein, not so much carbs. This way you can go longer between meals without having to chew if your mouth is really bothering you that bad. And in the beginning, you're not gonna be used to food getting lodged in your braces. Let me tell you guys, every time I ate something, I ran to the bathroom to brush my teeth. My husband was like, you're brushing your teeth again? Yeah, I got this food stuck in my teeth and it's really, really annoying. Yeah, that happens. But eventually, after a while, you kind of get used to it. You know, take you a swish of water, spit out, you know, if you got to, get you some mouthwash. You know, you don't necessarily have to brush every time or floss, but if it's bothersome for you, go ahead, go for it. In this article, it states to not floss several days after you've had your braces on. I tried flossing the night I had them on, and guys, let me tell you, this article is point on, because I could not get the floss in between my teeth. The wire had already started pulling everything so tight, there was no room to fit anything in between, and it was painful too, trying to, so I was like, nope, I can't do it. And it actually took me 2 days, I think, before I was able to floss. Here's a big one. After a week or two, and I think it actually took me sooner than that, your teeth are gonna feel loose. Literally, like I said, like someone hit you in the face with a baseball bat. Your teeth are gonna feel loose. But believe me, it's normal. and it's necessary. I have actually asked quite a few people that I've known had braces, and they say, yeah, that's just the adjustment. But that too will pass in another week or so. Since my tightening, things are feeling a little more stable instead of unstable, except for my two front ones here. They're still a little loose feeling. And they don't hurt unless I actually push on them, but I got the ligature ties on these, so they're a little more sensitive than the rest of my teeth anyways. Your bite is gonna change as time passes. Like I said, my bite I noticed was really off within a few hours after I had my braces put on, you guys. It didn't take any time at all. I, you know, thought, is this normal, you know, but it is. And, you know, eventually your bite kind of gets into a comfortable position before you go back in and have your braces tightened. I don't know if it gets in a comfortable position or if you just get kind of used to it. But like right now, my bite is completely off. Basically what's going on with mine, the reason why I don't have braces on my bottom teeth, because some of you might be wondering that too. And after I read over this article, it didn't really discuss that situation. The reason why is because my bottom teeth are more crowded than the top. So they're opening up my top arch to make more room in hopes that I don't have to have any tooth extractions. So this up here was not as wide. So basically my mouth went from like this, and it's opening up, which is creating, I got gaps in here, 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 and a few other places. So basically by opening up that arch, it's gonna create some gaps, which are gonna make room for my teeth to move in a straight position. Showing you guys real quick, it's gonna look like my bottom teeth are folding in, but that's because my top teeth are opening up. See that? It looks like I got some gaps there. So my top teeth are overlapping the bottom teeth by a little bit, and I can actually feel the difference with my tongue. And upon noticing any gaps in your teeth, don't worry, those will go away before treatment ends. They're gonna make sure everything, your bite is where it should be, your teeth are lining up perfectly, and there's no gaps. We've got meatloaf or meatballs, tuna, chicken, or egg salad, lunch meat, plain, not on a sandwich. Sandwiches could probably be too hard at the time. Soup, cheese slices, cooked eggs, which I love cooked eggs. French toast, pancakes, waffles, soft cooked meat like pot roast or roasted chicken. One thing that's not on this list that I've been eating that is soft is sushi, and I eat veggie sushi. So, and I eat the kind that has avocado, and avocado is really, really soft, so it's not gonna hurt your teeth. Baked or broiled fish, non-crusty bread without seeds or chunks, saltine crackers, because they'll just crumble at the roof of your mouth anyways. Cottage cheese, fruit, yogurt, custard type is best because the less chunks, the better. Cereal that gets soggy in milk, oatmeal or hot cereals. And I love me some oatmeal at the end of the day before I go to bed after I eat dinner and the kids are asleep. I'll fix me a nice hot bowl of oatmeal, and I'll put a slice of banana in it, and I'll take a good spoonful of peanut butter. Oh my gosh, guys, if you've never had peanut butter in your oatmeal, like your like the original oatmeal, the non-flavored kind, it is so, so, so good. Ice cream and cake, hey, what the hell, treat yourself. Frozen cheese, what is this, blintzes or potato pancakes. This is just going to be a list of some helpful tips that will help you survive the next few months or years in your braces. So you want to make or you want to buy a dental kit. I actually got a dental kit from my dentist whenever I went and had my braces put on, which looks like this. It looks like a little pencil case. And inside came with a lot of great essentials, which I'll show you guys. If you want to make one yourself and keep it in your car or in your briefcase, you can include in it a travel size or a full size toothbrush, a small tube of toothpaste, a folding cup so you can rinse, dental floss and floss threaders. I'm going to recommend you guys, the floss that you're going to want is the Oral-B Glide. You do not want that other floss that shreds and it's waxy. No, 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 no. You want Oral-B Glide because it will literally, it's like satin. It just slides right up in the teeth and it comes right out. The other stuff, your teeth are so tight, you guys, it will shred. So you don't want that kind. A spiral dental brush, which looks like this. Let's see. One of these little jazzy fellas. Looks like a little Christmas tree pipe cleaner thing. You're gonna want one of those. Some dental wax, a little mirror so that you can see, a packet of tissues, and some breath drops or spray if you want. Obviously, you can't have gum. You can keep all these portable dental supplies in a plastic zipper bag, or you can go to Walmart, Kmart, Target, wherever, and get a cosmetic sack. And guys, don't worry, you can get them and they can be solid black and people wouldn't know the difference. And you can get them without the handles, guys. And if you don't want to make one, I got a link I'll post down below this video where you can get your very own DentaKit braces survival kit. This one I haven't done yet. Brushing in a public restroom. Basically, they say face it, sooner or later you're gonna have to. I've been, you know, eating out and I haven't had to do that yet. This is one of the great things about having your own personal, you know, kit, because if you want, you can keep a bottle of water in your vehicle and you could just do it outside in your vehicle. I mean, you got mirrors all around your vehicle. So if you want, you could do it out there unless you choose to do it in a public restroom. Some people are self-conscious about that because they think, oh, these people are going to be watching me and thinking, ew, gross, she's spitting out chunks of food. It's totally, I mean, it's personal hygiene, you guys. I think it would be gross if you didn't do it. I mean, having braces, I mean, things get lodged in there and you definitely don't want to smile and be talking to somebody or thanking your waiter, you know, with a bunch of burger and fries all in your teeth and broccoli. One of the best public restrooms you could probably find to brush your teeth is one of those kind where you have the stall that has a sink in there, and or you could even go to one where it's just a single bathroom. There's not stalls in there. Everyone cleans their teeth slightly different from the other person. My routine is I will go in and I will just start with my toothbrush. I will get some water on it and I will start brushing, getting all the food out. If you want, you can rinse first to try to get all the anything in there loosened up. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't, but I'll start with just water on my toothbrush and I'll get all of everything that I possibly can off. Once I've done that, I'll rinse, I'll spit, I'll rinse, I'll spit. Then I'll put the toothpaste on my toothbrush and then I will brush. And I go like this over the top. And then I'll go like this over the appliances. But when I go over the appliances, I'm very careful doing it because I don't want to have one of my bands pop off. And then I'll go under like that. And then obviously get behind the teeth as well. When I'm done with that, if I haven't spit all my toothpaste out, I will add a little bit on this piece here. And I will go in between like that. And I'll kind of go over the top as well to make sure I get everything that may try to hide behind those brackets. Once I am done doing that and I've got all the food out of my teeth, I will then take my handy floss threaders, which look like sewing needles. And I got these in my kit, but you can get them from your orthodontist as well. And I just basically floss or thread my floss on here and you go up like this. Pull your floss and then you get it up in there and then I just pull my floss out. And I do that between each, sorry, my kids are outside and my neighbor's pulling out. So I want to make sure my kids aren't in his way. That's the whole reason why I had to have a root canal, because I failed at flossing and keeping into a routine with it. So a lot of food got up in there and got down in the tooth and my tooth started developing a cavity from the inside out, so I had no choice but for them to take the tooth. So now I've got a crown, which you can't tell. It's this one right here. Next is dealing with pain and discomfort, which we've already discussed. You can take, you know, something to relieve your pain, but after reading and hearing what my friend told me, I'm very hesitant on even telling you guys now, hey, yeah, jump on the NSAIDs, because now they're saying that they will slow down the progress. I guess, guys, just to be honest, check with your orthodontist and see what is best. And I don't really know, and she didn't know what the percentage of slowing down the progress it was gonna make in taking it. It may not affect you taking it one time. I mean, my teeth have been making really good progress. And when I first had my braces put on, you guys, I was taking some ibuprofen. So, and I made some really good improvement. I mean, they had me go from a 14 gauge wire to an 18 gauge wire. So some changes are happening, you know, regardless. So, I mean, it may not affect, you know, one individual as much as it could the other. After you've had your braces on for more than 6 months, your teeth start to get used to the pressure. I haven't had mine on for 6 months yet, but I think they're slowly starting to adjust to that pressure. When you go in for your adjustment, it may not hurt you at all. My adjustment that I had for the first time didn't even hurt me. I've only had my braces on since February 28th, and today is April 13th, is that right? So I've had my braces on for almost 2 months, you guys. For some people, your teeth may not feel sore again until your next adjustment, and that's basically how it's been for me. I hope that's how it is. Today, like I said, my teeth are just now to where they don't hurt me. The only thing is earlier today, I noticed my back teeth whenever I would bite down. There's more shifting that has taken place. So instead of my back teeth hitting like they should, they're more or less off a little bit. So yeah, that's exactly what it feels like. So here's my top and here's my bottom, and my top is just overlapping my bottom teeth, so my, like, the cuspids are hitting in a different location, and I guess the bite is a little harsh right now. Basically, cell regeneration, you guys. The process occurs after an adjustment. Your teeth are under so much force and they move, and it causes some cells, which is the bone and the tissue, to break down and new cells to regenerate. After regeneration happens, the teeth's supporting structures begin to move again, and the cycle continues. This is why most orthodontists see their patients every 4 to 5 weeks. My orthodontist has been seeing me so far every six. The cell regeneration process usually takes about 3 weeks. That gives the patients enough time after an adjustment before they have to have another one. Canker sores, they're nasty. You might get them, especially with these brackets, you guys, and these hooks on these brackets. I've already had a couple, and the one stuff that I have been recommended from my dentist, because I get canker sores most of the time anyways, and when I went in for my last cleaning, when I had to have my fillings done and my crown placed, my orthodontist had told me that, my dentist had recommended me to use this stuff right here, which is better than Or gel. This is the Colgate Or base, and this is just a little sample packet, but you can get it in a tube at your local retailer. So let me see if I can't get a better close-up for you guys. So yeah, definitely check into that stuff. It's basically like a paste, and it really sticks. It creates like a, like another coat of skin over that canker sore, and it doesn't rub in. It just stays there, and it numbs, and it really protects. It's some good stuff, so I definitely recommend it myself after trying it. Really, any toothbrush will work. As you can see, I just have been sticking with a manual toothbrush, but if you want, you can get you one of those electrical ones or battery operated ones. A lot of people love the Sonicare toothbrushes, so definitely check into those. They also have a toothbrush that the bristles have a V shape to them, so that you can get like up in the wires. I actually have this toothbrush here, and this has got like a rounding area. It kind of comes to a, like a V shape. This may actually be the toothbrush that they're talking about, but it helps get, you know, up in there, and it's the bristles, so it'll get things brushed. I haven't used that one yet, but I may consider it. Monthly adjustments. So you're basically going to have your braces adjusted every 4 to 6 weeks. This takes about 20 minutes. However, my last adjustment, just because I only have them on top, only took like maybe, I don't know, 10 to 12 minutes, if that. And contrary to what you think, it doesn't involve actually tightening anything. They just go in, they take the rubber bands off of each bracket, Then they take the wire off, and then your orthodontist will come in. He'll look at your teeth, and I'm going to tell you guys this because this is something that went in the article that I had, experienced just from personal experience. As soon as they took everything off and the wire out, my teeth felt like they were just dangling there. They felt like they were loose, just hanging there. But once the orthodontist looked at my teeth and my bite and everything, he said everything looked great. Then he went on ahead and proceeded to tell the assistant what wire to put in my mouth. And I was asked if I wanted the clear or the tooth colored wire, so it makes it a little more less visible, but they were out of the 18 gauge wire in that color, so I had to stick with the silver one, which still isn't bad. I don't mind it. Once they put the wire on, they go in and they start to put the rubber bands on, and that's when you start to feel like pressure and tightening, and that's it. The only thing different this time I had with mine was her putting the ligature ties on there, which I don't know if you can see. Let's see. Yeah, you can see one right here. Right there, that little wire. So I got one there, and I got on this one and this one too. So those are attached to the wire in the bracket, and it's to help pull my teeth that are slightly crooked forward instead of backwards the way that they're facing. Part 5 of this article basically talks about adults, the forgotten audience, because you see a lot of kids nowadays getting braces and not so much adults. We shouldn't have to ignore the fact that it should feel like a big deal for us to want to get our teeth straightened just because we're older. Teeth are teeth. I mean, you don't see people going and being like, oh, I'm you know, older, so I'm not gonna go and have this done and that done, you know. It's kind of irrelevant to the decision. But so many adults have braces nowadays, you guys, and it's becoming more common. According to the American Association of Orthodontists, more than 1 million adults in North America have braces. It says, consider this, many adults wore braces as kids. Many adults have kids who are or were in braces. Many adults think about getting braces themselves. It's been months and years, and now your teeth look beautiful and you got them exactly where you want them. So this is all new to me, so I'm gonna read from this article. When your braces are ready to be removed, your dentist or orthodontist will clip the curve on the back of the braces with a special plier. This breaks the adhesive bond between the bracket and your tooth. While it does make a loud clipping sound, it doesn't really hurt. As Dr. E. Coles in Florida explains, no, we don't pull them off. The plastic bonding material is simply fractured gently off the back of each bracket, and all the brackets come off with the wire. If the wire is left in place, then they gently squeeze the brackets. So each bracket is popped off clean, which leaves a layer of the bonding plastic on the tooth, and then they use a high-speed handpiece to smooth the plastic off of the teeth and polish the enamel where the plastic was removed. And then they'll finish up with a polishing disc to smooth the enamel. The R word, retainers. You've spent several months and years in these braces. Are your teeth really done? Not really. You have to wear a retainer to keep your teeth in their new positions. If not, things are gonna shift and move around, and all that money and time you just spent and a little bit of pain getting those teeth straightened are gonna go back to their original form. It is very important to wear your retainer, as your orthodontist insists you to, especially during the first year that your braces come off. They have definitely informed me of that already. Basically, it's going to take 9 months for the periodontal ligaments to remember their new positions. So if you don't wear your retainer regularly, your teeth are going to shift. After the first year, many people wear their retainers at night, then several nights a week, to ensure that their new smiles continue to look great. And there are 3 basic retainers, you guys. So you have the Holly retainers, which are made of a acrylic, and it is molded to your mouth, and they contain a wire to hold your teeth in position, which is a common type of retainer. The acrylic part is available in clear and also a variety of colors and interesting designs, so you can personalize your retainer if you wish. Pros of that retainer is it will hold your teeth securely in position. Your orthodontist can actually bend the wires to do some final tweaking on your smile. So that's a good thing with that retainer. The cons is the wire across your teeth is obviously visible, and it takes a few weeks to get used to wearing it. That retainer was not in my treatment plan, so I don't have to worry about that one. And if any of you are wondering exactly what those retainers look like, I'll include a picture of that here. So the next set of retainers that they have are the Essex, I believe is what they call them, but it is very similar to what Invisalign is. It's the clear ones. Some people love these while others feel they are too uncomfortable. Make you talk funny. They just feel funny because you don't feel like your teeth are hitting where they should when you're chewing or talking. The pros is it is virtually invisible on your teeth. It does not rest on your palate and they're comfortable. The cons is it does not allow your teeth to touch in a natural way and it cannot move teeth, so there's no tweaking by your orthodontist. You need to be careful not to warp it in hot water as well. Then they have what they call permanent retainers. I have already been told that in my treatment plan I will be wearing the one very similar to Invisalign, just on the top. Now the one that I'll get for the bottom is gonna be different, which is this one that I'm fixing to read to you guys. It's called a permanent retainer, or a bonded retainer is what they refer to it as. It is glued to the back of your teeth and it's never removed. It's there, it's permanent. The pros is you cannot see the retainer and it retains the teeth perfectly and is often used in cases where a large relapse may occur. The cons, the downside to this, is it can bother your tongue and it takes some getting used to, so it can be difficult to floss the teeth bonded to the retainer, so you will need a floss threader. So guys, oh my goodness, so it looks like these are gonna be in my life for the rest of my life, because I'm gonna have to use them once I get the bonded retainer. So basically it goes behind, and I'll include a picture of what that looks like here. Your orthodontist will help you decide what retainers are going to be best for you, and whatever type you and your orthodontist choose to go with, it is important that you wear it regularly. Your orthodontist will also explain to you during your treatment plan, hopefully during your consult, about how long you will need to wear your retainer, and then when you can remove it and then start wearing, like basically you'll kind of taper down on wearing it as much. So I believe with me, on the top one, I think he said that I would be wearing it for the first, month, I think, or 6 weeks, something like that. And then I will start wearing it like every day, but only at night. And then I can start probably wearing it a few times a week. Knowing me, I'm probably gonna be that person that wears it every single night when I go to bed, just because I don't want to spend this amount of time and money on braces and risk them shifting at all. And if you get a retainer, cleaning, you know, obviously that's still a personal hygiene thing. You want to keep those things clean. So how can you keep your retainer clean? They have products on the market that you can use. They have something called Sonic Bright, Retainer Bright. I didn't even know they made stuff like that, so that was new to me. I learned something from that. So yeah, some very helpful information. Like I said, there will also be some links in the description below this video for you guys to check out. I hope this was a great 101 informative video for you guys to learn a little bit more about braces and what to expect. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And I want to give thanks to Archwired for providing some great information that I was so eager to share with you guys. It was nice also being able to share my personal experience with you as well. I definitely don't want to sugarcoat things because I don't want to steer people in the wrong direction thinking, oh, braces, you know, yeah, let's go for it. Sounds so cool and fun. It's not always cool and fun, you guys. There is, you know, pros and cons to everything, so definitely consider those. If you're not subscribed to my channel, make sure you click that red subscribe button and check me out every other week for now, unless I have a fun video like this one to post for you guys in between that. If you have any questions or comments, please list them below. Any tips or advice, or if any of you out there might have some tips or advice based on your experience with braces in the past, or maybe you're currently in them and you have some awesome ideas you want to share with us and everyone else, please list them below. And I will talk to you guys next week for my week 8 braces update, you guys. 2 months in. Oh my goodness. Cannot believe it. So I will talk to you guys then. Bye.